Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements video, we'll be doing this smoke effect portrait. We'll be starting this off over in the Gimp program, doing the smoke over in the Gimp program, and then bringing it over in here to Photoshop Elements to finish all of the compositing work. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and hit share. Also, subscribe if you haven't already done so. To support my channel, I have a link for Patreon up on the channel homepage, and if you want to learn a lot more about Photoshop Elements, take a look at my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Here's the smoke photograph we'll be using in this smoke portrait, and I currently have this open up in the free GIMP program. If you don't have GIMP, again, it's a free download, and it works well with Photoshop Elements. Now, it's more difficult to use, but it has some features that really help us out here, especially on this one particular project, and that we can take a look at channels. So here's the smoke picture. The very top up here, right hand side, we have our panels. Above that, there's this one here with kind of a multicolored thing, red, green, and blue. Those are the channels. And you can see the different channels here. Top one is red, middle one is green, and the bottom one is blue. If you click on the blue channel, it will say blue right there. Right click on that, and we can then take that channel to a selection. So there's our selection, just like that. Now this is a selection of just what's on the blue channel, and that's something which we can't do over in Elements, so this is useful for that. Okay, right next to this multicolor little thing here, these are the channels, we have the layers right there, and we're now on layers. There's that background layer. Go up to edit and come down to copy. There we go. Now go back up to edit again and come down to paste. What that does is it gives you this new floating selection, pasted layer. We need to now set this as an actual layer, so right click where it says floating selection and choose to new layer. And there it is, it's now on a layer. I can now hide the background, and there is just the blue channel of that smoke. Now it's a bit more difficult here, obviously, to do these kinds of things here in GIMP, but I'll put the instructions for this particular project on my download page so you can find these specific step-by-steps to make this easy to do. If you follow the steps along, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you'll have no problem getting it to this point. Okay, let's go ahead and finish this one off. File and save. Now it's going to want to save it in the GIMP format, which is the XCF format. I'll just choose save, that's fine. There we go. And then come down to export. Here's the export dialog. We want to select the file type. It's right down here. Click on that plus sign, and then we'll scroll down until we find the PNG file format, which is right there, PNG image. At this point, you can choose to find a different location for this or create a folder. I'll save it in the same location. I'll then open it up from that location over in Photoshop Elements. I'll just put in here dash portrait on that and choose export. And the reason for that is so it doesn't save on top of the original file. I want to keep that one safe. So export. I'll leave all of these things at their defaults. That's just fine. And then click export again. And once that's done, there we go. So now I have this saved as a PNG file, and it's just the smoke with transparency for everything else. And we're all set to go. We can now close down the GIMP program and then open up Photoshop Elements, which I'll do right now. There we go. Let's now make a new file in here. File, new, blank file. I'll leave it at the Photoshop default size here, the Elements default size. Choose OK. There it is. I'll dock that right there. And let's maximize that to the window. There it is. We can now place in that smoke picture. Now, if you don't want to get GIMP and hassle with all that GIMP stuff, then I also have this smoke picture with a transparent background downloadable from my site. You'll find a link for that in the description. Let's go ahead and grab that picture here, place, and there it is right there. There's the smoke with the background removed, and choose place. I'll now grab the corner here, and let's maximize this as much as possible. And then click OK. So there's the basic smoke in here. Now I want to have this vertical instead of at an angle like that. So we'll do a Control T keyboard shortcut that brings back up those control handles. Come outside over here, left hand side is easy. Let's just spin this until it's basically straight up and down right there, and pull it down a little bit, and that's pretty good. So there's the basic smoke. Now we need to convert the colors in here, or those browns that I like. And it's easy to do. We're just going to be inverting this. But before I do that, take a look up here at the layer. See this little icon right down there? That means that this was brought in as a smart layer. I want to get rid of that. So right click on the name and choose Simplify Layer. It's now just a graphic picture. Let's now clean up these edges right here, these straight edges. And for that, we need a layer mask. So click on the layer mask button. There it is. Now it's all white and white shows, so we're seeing the whole thing. If we take the black paintbrush, I have mine set right now at 200 pixels. You can see there's the size of the paintbrush. And if I paint black on the layer mask, just like this, it's going to hide any place where I'm painting in black. And just come in here and clean around some of those hard edges. So it's either a nice soft bit or just kind of fade that out. It'll look a lot more realistic without having those hard edges. Just kind of give it away that it's been clipped out of something. So we'll just fix the hard edges. Kind of like that. And a little bit over here, it looks like. And that looks pretty good. Now, click over on the layer side, or double click on the layer side, and let's convert this over to those browns. Now it's easy to do here. I'm just going to be inverting this image. Go up to Filter, come down to Adjustments, and Invert. And there's our browns and our smoky effect. Let's now make a duplicate of this layer. Just drag it up here to the New Layer button. There's our duplicate. Now we can bring in our portrait photograph. Back up to File and Place, and there it is. Again, I had these all set for downloads. Just look in the description for the link. And we'll place our portrait, and that's fine. It just comes in right at the right spot. That's great. Just click on the green check mark. There we go. Now I need to remove her background out of here, and we'll do that using Refine Edge with a selection. So I'll start off with the Polygonal Lasso tool, and I'll make just a little simple lasso, just in pretty close to her hair, but not touching. It's real wispy, you can kind of go through it right there, that's fine. And let's just come around and make a nice little lasso in here. When you're using this tool, don't go too quickly with it or the selection will collapse on you and you have to start over again. Now come outside the picture or on the bottom, stay outside down here, and then bring it back in again. And continue around the outside of our portrait. Just up around this side, up around the top, up here, and then you can go outside here and you can go straight across the top and then right back down to your beginning point. And there's our selection. Make sure that you go clear around right back to the beginning on your selection. You want to have a closed selection here. Okay, back up to Select, come down to Refine Edge. Here's a Refine Edge tool. See, there's that Refine Edge brush. I'm going to set this for a larger size. Set this at 70 pixels, that's better. And then I'll set Smart Radius. And then just paint out here. Keep that plus sign out in the red side of her hair as opposed to in the image side of the hair. And just paint right along that edge. And do this in little strokes, like that. And then Photoshop Elements goes in and refigures that edge for you. And it'll give us a real nice, clean selection. You can kind of work in here if you have some open areas like that. Just go ahead and just work in on those. And it'll do a real nice job on this. There we go. Let's get the top. And let's work up around the top like that. That's fine. Over this side is fine. And again, just a little short steps in here. And let elements think between steps. And then we'll finish off right down the back. There we go. All done. Okay, now let's save this out to a new layer. So it's down here, it says Output 2. Choose New Layer with Layer Mask, and OK. Here's our new layer. There's our layer mask. Now notice we're seeing some of that smoke hiding in behind there. That's perfectly fine. Go back to the standard Move tool up here. Now I'm going to be taking this layer and drag it underneath the original layer, which is right there. Just drag it down like that. And then over here it says WOM. Of course, that stands for Woman. See what the whole thing says in here. There you go. There's the name of the file right there. Right click and then choose Create Clipping Mask. What that does is it takes this picture and puts it inside of the smoke right down here. So we now have a picture inside of the smoke. And that takes care of that smoky part of her picture. We now need to bring her face back in again, and we'll do that up here with this top layer. Just click on that. The whole thing is showing, so we need to hide everything except just for her face and a little bit back here at the back side of her head. So on this layer, click on the layer mask button. There it is. Now come down to the layer underneath, to that layer mask. Look for that light blue outline. Hold the Alt key down and then drag this up to the other layer mask right there and then choose Yes. What that does is it copies this layer mask up to here. Now we don't see it. If you just show and hide that, there it is. Sometimes it's not really obvious on that. So there's our top layer mask. Now on this one, we can then paint on this layer mask here in black. Black hides, white shows. So let's reverse our colors. I have my paintbrush on here, 200 pixels and a soft edge brush. And if I paint in here, I'm hiding what's on that layer and just going to show the layer underneath. I'm going to leave just the smoky stuff underneath here pretty much. And that's pretty good over here. Now around in here, it's kind of soft and fuzzy in there. We get some of those little stray hairs in there. I want to take those out, but I want to be careful about that. And I want to clean this part up here. So let's change our brush. I'll just scroll down and change this down to a hard edge brush right here. And let's bring our size up maybe to about 100. There it is. I'm still on the layer mask. This way I can come back and fix it later if I want to. I'm just going to clean up along this edge just a little bit in here. Just like that. That's going to be a bit too hard, but we'll fix that in just a second. And let me just clean up around the top there. That's pretty good. Now go up to this tool right here. This is the blur tool. You see, there it is. And just paint right along that edge. And that will soften that edge up. That'll just help blend things together. Okay, there we go. Now, come down to the bottom layer down here. Back up here to the Move tool. And just pull that to the right. That's our bottom layer. And I'll pull that out a little ways here. Maybe down just a bit so you get a little different positioning. In here someplace, you can see there's kind of that the shapes right there. I'll put it right about here. That's pretty good. And that gives us the additional smokiness over here on the right-hand side. Now I have one little problem here, and that's that line right there. And we can fix that. That's on the layer mask again. That's why we have our layer mask. You want to hide that. So we have our black. Go to the paintbrush. Change this to a soft brush. I'll just scroll down and grab that 200 brush right there. And then right at the top, just on the layer mask, paint black right in there. And that just hides that hard edge. And I'll just break up that shape a little bit. There we go. And that gives us that nice smokiness over here on the right-hand side. So left-hand side is good. Right-hand side is pretty good. I now want to do just a little tweak on the values in here on the right-hand side. And that's going to be the visible values, and that's this layer right here. So let's put an adjustment layer right there on that bottom smoke layer. So let's go up here to a layer, come down to adjustment layer, and hue saturation. Where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask, make sure that is checked, and choose OK. And here we can adjust the saturation and the lightness. What I want is less saturation on that. And that pulls color out of it. You see there's a lot more color. There's a lot less color. So I'll set this in here to a negative 46. Just pulling out some of the color, making it just more of a gray, a little bit of brown edge to it. and let's lighten it up just a little bit. See, there's real light. So you can use this to help to blend that in. I think just a little bit lighter, about plus 10 looks pretty good. So just little tweaks. And that helps her backside of her head here to stand out better from that smoke, and then close that down. Okay, all we have left to do now is to fix the position. She's a bit too much over here on the right-hand side and too much space left-hand side. I want just a little bit to the left. So for that, click on the top layer, hold the shift key down, click on the bottom layer. Don't click on the background, but everything else. And then I'll use the left arrow key. I'm just going to tap her over just a little bit until she's a little bit better placed in the page. Right about here is pretty good. So there we go. And there it is. That's doing our smoke portrait here inside of Photoshop Elements. The only tricky part about this whole thing really is just getting that original smoke picture. And I showed you how to do that in the free GIMP program. If you want to get that program, I'll give you a link in my download page where you can download the program. It's, again, free. So it's a nice one to have with your Photoshop Elements. If you don't want to go to the trouble, I also have this picture as a download with the transparent background, again, on the download page. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Also click on share and share with your friends through social media. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, don't forget to support my channel. There's a link for Patreon, you know, 50 cents, a dollar a month, whatever will help a lot on keeping this channel going. And to really learn how to use Photoshop Elements, look for my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description.